Hi, this is Overspot.
I'm George.
Let's continue looking at how I achieve productivity using containers. So, on this episode, we will look at how I set up and use AWS CLI using containers instead of installing the actual tool and its dependencies on my machine. So, let's start coding. If you are more comfortable running command line interfaces or CLIs over, say, logging into a web console and checking the properties of your infrastructure resources, most likely you've been using AWS CLI quite a lot. I do. So in the past, the way AWS CLI is installed on our machines is that we need to install two other components or tools. You've got Python and pip. So that means you don't only need to worry about setting up AWS CLI, but you also have to set up two other tools that you're most likely not going to be using for a while. With AWS CLI in Docker, you need not worry about Python and pip because all these dependencies are being taken care of for you. So all the dependencies are encapsulated within the Docker package itself. So you set up once for all. So let's have a look at how I set up and use AWS CLI in Docker. So if I open my terminal, if I issue AWS and run that, it says command not found. So I don't have AWS CLI installed on my machine. And then if I quickly check images that I've pulled, it's empty. So that means we're actually starting fresh. So we will try to break this episode into two parts. First part is we will look into the different AWS CLI commands in the Docker command form. These are going to be long commands, but on the second stage, we will try to set up some wrapper scripts. This episode also assumes that you have basic knowledge of Docker. So if you're new to Docker, I'd suggest go have a read through at least the basic usage and commands and then come back to this video. So enough of the chat, let's do some actual work. So in my home directory, I have a directory called workspace. And then I just cd to that directory. And then inside workspace, I created another directory called scripts, which will contain all the work that we're doing here. And then I launch VS Code to start the work. There you go. So let's launch our terminal in here and then toggle the Explorer. And then we'll start doing most of the work from here. So first things first, I already have a profile that's set up on my machine. And it's, as you know, if you've been working with AWS CLI for quite a while, it's sitting in my home directory. AWS. What I'm going to do is I'm going to move this out. And call it SWA for now. The reason I'm doing that is I want to show you how to create the profile. So if I go back to my workspace scripts, clear that out. The image is called Amazon AWS-CLI. So let's pull that image into our local machine. And then once that's pulled, let's try running docker run --rm. If you have a look at the documentation, it's intended to clean up the containers that are spun up by this run. And then what I want to do as well is I want to map my local home directory to the root directory inside the container, and then reference the Docker image. And then subsequent commands, so next to the image will be your usual AWS CLI commands without the AWS in front. So let's just say, let's run a basic one, S3 LS. So this should fail and complain about missing profile. So that's what we're gonna do. Instead of S3 LS configure. But what I want to do is, because this is going to prompt me for some values, I need to add -it to make the run interactive. It will prompt you for your access key ID and then all the other values. Because I've already got one, I'll cancel that and then move back my .swa into .aws. So when you run AWS configure, it sets up a default AWS account that you use. So every time you run your AWS commands, it will always use that default account that you've set up. You can also set up a name profile in here. So if I recall that command, instead of just issuing configure, you can go profile and then your name profile. So let's just say tester. And then again, it will ask you for access key ID, etc. Let me exit that. Because I've renamed and I've set up back my AWS credentials, let's try to run the AWS S3LS once again. But this time, let's get rid of the interactive switch and run that. And now it shows the list of S3 buckets that have been set up on my AWS account. So in my setup, I do have a default profile and I have another profile called developer. So if I export my AWS profile equal now, and then I'll recall that command, and then I pass an environment variable called AWS profile. So what this does is it uses whatever AWS profile that I've defined on my local machine when running the CLI inside the container. So if I run that, it shows me the S3 buckets configured on my account. So now if I change my profile to developer, which doesn't have access to the S3 bucket, I run that again, this will fail and it will say access denied. So now that we know how AWS CLI commands are being run using Docker, I think we're now ready to set up a wrapper script for this. So inside the scripts, we'll create a file called AWS, and let's set this up as a shell script. Let me toggle the Explorer, adjust my terminal a little bit, and then in here, all we need to do is copy that whole thing. And then, instead of passing S3LS, we'll do @ sign. Just get rid of that for now. So what that means is, let me save this so we see what the effect. And then we change the permission of the script. That's executable. And now, if I do /AWS S3LS, we get the access denied. And then let's say export AWS profile back to the default. And then run that. We get the list of S3 buckets. Now the next thing that we need to do is, instead of that /AWS commands, we can then start setting up an alias for this command. So let me just quickly have a look at the current working directory scripts. And then what we need to do is I'm using ZSH. So I'm gonna change my RC. Let me just quickly copy this, because this is the path to the AWS script that we want to run. Open my RC file, and then at the end, I'm going to insert alias AWS equals AWS, and then save that. And then remember, this is not gonna take effect immediately, so you want to source CSHRC. So now if I just run AWS, now it recognizes my command. And then if I run AWS S3LS, that's as if I've got my AWS CLI configured on my machine. One other thing that I find very useful, especially if I need some suggestions or I need to know how the command is being used, is an auto-completion. So before we look into setting that up, so that we appreciate what's going on in the background, let's get inside the container. And then I'm going to show you another AWS tool that's packaged within the container that does the auto-completion for us. So if I go to user local bin, this will have all the AWS CLI commands that we use. So you've got the main AWS as well as the AWS completer. So these are compiled, but what we need to do is we need to set up the AWS completer so we can use the auto completion and suggestion tool. So if we exit that, so what that means is if I go AWS S3 and hit tab to get some suggestions, it will complain about AWS completer not being around, because it's trying to look for that script from within our machine, my local machine. So to set that up, I need to create another script in here called AWS_completer. Let's copy this. Let's toggle the Explorer so we can see more. And then, instead of doing this, I'm not gonna map my home, and then I'm not gonna pass my profile. But what I need is, I want it to be interactive, because it will call AWS, the actual AWS CLI command. And then I want to override the default command in AWS CLI to use the AWS completer inside the container, which we just saw earlier. And then I need to pass some environment variables. So those environment variables are called comp_line. Actually, the line is getting longer, so let's break this out. Slash. And then break that up. And then break that up. So there's two environment variables that I need to pass. It's comp line and comp one. And then that's our AWS completer. Then we also need to change the permission of that file to executable. U+X. And then once that's done, we need to set up our RC file. Such that the AWS completer will be utilized. So we set up an auto load command from entry of the shell and set comp init and then run that. And then we also need to auto load the bash version of this. And then in here we set up a complete command pointing to AWS completer. Now let's use tick instead of quotes. So let me fix that. And then change this to AWS completer. And then the actual command, AWS. Save that. Source the RC file again. And then now, what I want to do is run AWS S3 and then hit tab, and then it will pull out the suggestions. And then if I say use another resource like SSM, do you wish to sell all 132 possibilities? I think it's because there's a lot of possible options to display. So let's just say yes, and then that's the list. If I switch my profile to the developer, let's just do EC2 describe. Developer profile doesn't have access to any of the resources for security reasons. So there has to be a separation of what a particular profile can access versus what other profiles can. That's it. So there you have it. Don't forget to drop me some likes if you find this video useful. Send me some comments below. And don't forget to subscribe. Until next time, remember, you learn more by doing. See ya.